In this video, we'll talk about creating a new design, and of course there's several ways to start a new design. From your welcome window, there's the option to create new design, and whatever within this welcome window, whatever setting for machine and fabric you have. So if I set this right now for, let's say, the MC15000, and I select the 140 by 140 hoop, and then you select any color of fabric or type of fabric that you want and say create new, then this is the fabric and the hoop that comes onto your screen. And I can just zoom out and show you that that's the, you know, the 140 hoop for the MC15000 that came onto my screen. If I say on my, within this, see what happens is I create a tab for this design, and you can have multiple designs open at the same time. If I just click on the button that says new right now, it starts another new design. See, I have new design number one and new design number two. And new design number two is based on the same machine and the same fabric that I most currently used. So if I go back to my welcome screen and change that to be, you know, my MB7 and maybe the larger hoop for the MB7 in a slightly different color fabric, and say okay, and say create new, this is the new fabric and design which I get created. Not only that, if I say new, then the next new design is also based on that. So I have several new design 1, 2, 3, 4 that are open right now. Another way you can start a new design is under the file drop-down menu where it says new. And so there's several options into, I guess, how you can create your next new design. These are, when I say a new design, it basically means an empty workspace that you could then add to with your, you know, digitizing tools or shape tools or lettering tools and things that we'll describe in more detail later. But all of these designs are simply called new design until which time that we choose to save them, at which point we'll be given the option to give them a proper name. So we'll talk about saving designs next.